Okay, this is a first exercise problem you are going to do for assignment. So this is going to be the exercise one in the 33rd chapter in this book by Chaba Zapaswari and Latimore. So what this exercise wants you to show is, it asks you to show that fix the number of rounds, says that there exists a distribution nu such that whatever policy we are going to apply, the regret is going to like grow like at least square root k by n. So where e c is a constant. So it is saying that there exists nu, and it says that okay, nu is so it says that so this is the class of sub Gaussian random variables with parameter 1. You would say so there exists a nu belonging to this class such that irrespective of whatever pi you are going to choose, you are going to incur regret, which is of the order square root k by t for some constant c. So how to work out this? This is an exercise, and this has a hint also in that exercise, like this follows along the similar lines which you did it in the adversarial case, right? You there also you came up with an algorithm where you showed that there exists an adversary who can select a sequence such a way that your regret is going to be like at least grow like square root t. Along that you are going to show this, okay. And another thing, so if you are now going to look into this, is your uniform exploration is already optimal? For uniform exploration, what is the bound we got? We got it like k log k by t, right? So okay, 2 is a constant, you can ignore that, but if you are going to compare for with parameters k and t, the only extra parameter I have here is log k. Otherwise it is already k by t, right, under root of k by 2. So in that means it is already optimal up to this factor log k. Another exercise in the same chapter, it asks you to show that yes, this uniform exploration is optimal up to this factor log k, but you can't avoid this factor log k here. For uniform exploration, it will be always there. So you have to show that if you are going to use uniform exploration, this is going to be always for k log k delta. So for uniform exploration, you can't avoid this. Maybe there is a other policy, better policy, which will going to achieve this lower bound, but uniform policy is not that optimal. It is this extra factor log k. So both of them you will do for assignment 4. Okay, now fine. Now the question is, is there a policy which will achieve this lower bound for my simple regret? The answer turns out to be positive. If that's the case, then the question we have to answer is, what is that policy? Okay. Suppose, let's say I am going to this is also a stochastic case, right? Instead of cumulative regret, we are looking at simple regret. Suppose, let's say instead of worrying about a special algorithm for this, I will just take one of the algorithm which I have already for the stochastic multi-arm bandit, let's say UCB or KL-UCB. I will take, and for the whatever it is going to do, let it do it in the exact way it is doing, but whatever arm it is going to select in the t plus 1th round, for that round I am going to compute its instantaneous regret. So do you think if I do that, it should give me a better performance? Like that should be good. Okay, so let's say I will give you a time t, capital T. What you do is you just apply your UCB algorithm, let's say whatever you did till t round, you did it, and whatever you are going to it asks you to select in the t plus 1th round, that you give me as the output in the t plus 1th round, and then I am going to compute simple regret on that. Do you think the performance of that is going to be good or bad? Why is that? Yeah, but there also it has to be doing some optimization, right? If it is not bothering about optimization each round, its regret won't be sublinear. It has to also do some optimization, right? For every round. We are exploring less over there.
Compared to this.
Yeah, but so in that case, most of the time it will be picking the optimal arm, right? Or it will be exploiting if it is doing a good job. If it is already exploiting it, it's better be exploiting the best arm. If it is exploiting some arm, right, that means it believes that that is the best arm, right. So it could be also exploring in that. The way the UCBs are selecting, it has both exploitation term plus exploration term in, right? It may be happening at some point, it may in the, if you are unlucky, it may be happening that in the t plus 1 round it went into exploitation term become dominant and it is exploring some arm. So in that case it won't be giving a good performance to you, right? But that is not UCB. I'm just saying if you have to just plainly take it and apply it, give it whatever it is doing. Okay, but okay, other way, like thinking like you, suppose let's say I took UCB, so I have given time t, I just took the UCB and I just see how many arms it played till this point, each one of the arms, and then I am going to pick the arm which is played highest number of times. If I do this, so you expect it should have a better simple regret? Yeah. So that means if you are going to just pick the arm which has been so far played highest number of time, you should, do you expect that to be already the best one, or that should give the smallest sample regret? So then you are saying, yes, it depends on t. If t is large enough, then maybe like I would have explored all of them sufficiently good amount and I have good confidence in each one of them, then maybe I will just pick the one which I have been selecting most number of the times. If t is small, I don't have that much confidence, right? Because who knows, like I may not have. Yeah.
Can UCB help us differentiate between those two perhaps in a better way as compared to?
But that is not the goal here, right? I don't want, I just want how best, whether
so
what.
UCB will obviously differentiate between the rest as well as this as well.
See, like, rest I distinguish fine, but the two ones which are very close to each other,
yes.
If I have not yet resolved them, finally when I have to give one arm, which one?
But UCB will pick both of those linear times,
right?
But this one will pick t by k time.
So fine, so in that case, like if you are in a bad situation where two arms are very close,
yes,
it has not yet figured out which one of them is better, and so it might be playing them equal number of times.
But
so because of that, so you take the whatever the empirical means. What I want is at that time in the t plus 1 on whatever it is going to play, whether it is going to, how far it is going to from the optimal arm is the question, whether it is going to be good or not. It may be right, like still suppose if you are saying okay, two arms are very close to each other and it has been playing them for quite a some time to distinguish which one of them is better. Now in the t plus 1 round, you just ask okay, pick one, it should be picking one of these two, right? Because it is trying to resolve between these two, and because these two are close, it may happen that even their sample regret also won't be that much, because they are almost like very, they are their difference is not that much.
All the remaining arms will
okay, so you are saying Doing UCP is not bad in that case. We should better take this sample. So fine, that's what I'm asking, like whether you will go for a UCB and just take whatever it says in the T plus round for the simple regret. So it depends on the problem instance, right? So you can't like blindly apply it on any problem instance given to you. So for a simple regret, you have to be more careful. But still, if I want to still get a bound on, if I want to adapt an algorithm that is there for an standard which is designed for regret minimization to a case where I want to do a simple regret minimization, what could be the case? One possible thing I could do is, based on number of times I have observed each of these arm till time t, I am going to now construct a probability distribution on the arms which is proportional to the number of times I have played each one of them. And then I am going to pick a one according to this probability distribution. So we will see that if there is a good algorithm for the regret minimization problem, and if you are going to do like this in the T plus 1th round, that is, you are going to construct a probability distribution based on how many times your regret minimization algorithm has played till time t, then even your simple regret would be good. So let's understand this. So first, I want to express simple regret in terms of the cumulative regret. So this is a proposition I'm going to write. So let to regret. So let pi defined like this be a policy, and I am going to, so this is defined for the first capital T rounds. Now you are going to define this policy for the T plus 1th round in this fashion. What you are going to say? You are going to say that we are going to play ith arm given that you have been observing, okay, this is like I1 in our notation, I1 it. That is, you have played I1 in the first round, observed reward R1, and in the ith round you played it arm and you observed reward it. We are going to define this quantity to be what? To be the average of this indicator. What is this going to give you? It is going to give you, so what is this p t plus 1 is going to give you? It is going to give a distribution on the arms, right? And what is, how is this distribution is going to be? That is going to be proportional to the number of the times you have played that particular arm. Now if you are going to do this, and now if you are going to compute a simple regret of the policy, where you take the first three rounds like this, you have, and for the t plus 1th round you have exactly done like this, then the simple regret of that algorithm is going to be cumulative regret of the policy pi that was playing like this in the first whatever it is, it was whatever the policy is, it has done something till first round, first t rounds, like pi 1, pi 2, all the way up to pi t. Then this simple regret is going to be nothing but the cumulative regret divided by this capital T. That is, the average of this cumulative regret is exactly equal to your simple regret. So why is that true? So let us write my cumulative regret. I know my cumulative regret is given by what? Expected value of is this correct? Cumulative regret is this. We know that this is by the regret decomposition theorem. Now, let me divide it by NIT. So, what is NIT here is? NIT is gives you the number of times you have played arm I till round T. So, is this NIT is going to be same as this quantity here? No. What is this? This is nothing but this distribution pi T plus 1, right? So, then can I write this as, this is this expectation as nothing but I just does del of I this is del I t plus 1, whatever the arm we selected, this is exactly this distribution. So then this is nothing but, and this is nothing but, this is the simple regret. So my simple regret if you give me any policy which I can apply to get a good cumulative, which I can apply for the cumulative regret minimization problem, and if I am going to, at the end, if I am going to sample my t plus 1 term according to the distribution defined like this, then the cumulative regret, the average of the cumulative regret is nothing but my simple regret for that policy pi. So, what I have basically done is, I took a policy pi here, which I am applying it on the standard bandit problem to minimize cumulative regret, but the way I am pulling the t plus 1 round is based on this new distribution. If I do this, I am just saying that this is how the simple regret and the cumulative regret are related. This is the simple regret that I would have got in t plus 1th round, and this is the cumulative regret in the first t rounds. Okay. Now can you tell me what is the best bound? So given this relation holds, now can you tell me what is the best simple regret bound I can get? Order root k by t. Root k, whatever, one single big root k by t. Yes. So why is that? Right. So I know that, which is that algorithm? Moss algorithm. If I use my Moss algorithm, that already guarantee me some order square root k t. But because of the denominator t here, I am going to get it as order square root k divided by t, which is what this lower bound also tells. So, if I have a good algorithm for my cumulative regret, I have a good algorithm for simple regret, but it does not like look like as simple as it is. It is not necessary that any algorithm which performs well on the that gives a good cumulative regret necessarily has to yield a good simple regret. So that we'll talk a bit later, but let me just for complete this statement here as a corollary. For all there exist, a policy such that for all so as you already see that what is that there exists a policy, this policy which is giving me this bound is already Moss policy, right? So okay, so fine, so let me first discuss. So this corollary says that for all t there exists a policy such that for any instance this relation holds. We are giving an upper bound. Lower bound we are already given here. This is irrespective of what is your policy, there exists an instance such that this lower bound holds. Now we have to give an if see that we can achieve this. What we are saying is there exists a policy such that for any instance this holds. Now you already know what is that policy. This policy is Moss policy, because that gives me a square root kt regret, and from that I am going to achieve square root k by t regret.